that you are deserving of love and respect.
Years, countless times.
A lot of us, and I would say especially women, are extremely hard on ourselves.
We have to break this.
We have to get out of these toxic relationships. We have to get out of these toxic environments. Is when a person completely lacks self-love, completely lacks healthy self-compassion. Now, what is self-compassion and what is healthy self-love? Well, a person with healthy self-compassion and self-love will have a healthy self-image, will have a sense of worth for themselves. So without being a narcissist, without believing that you are at the center of the universe, but having value for yourself, believing that you are worthy, believing that you have worth, believing that you are deserving of respect, that you are deserving of love and respect and belonging, that you have self-respect, right? Now, what does that look like practically, right? I think that one of the biggest sort of traps that we fall into, and I've heard this over the years countless times, a lot of us, and I would say especially women, are extremely hard on ourselves. And when I say that we are hard on ourselves, I don't mean that, you know, we push ourselves to be our best in a healthy way. I mean that we beat ourselves up, and it is not healthy. And one of the ways that that also sabotages self-worth, and that is the way in which we speak to ourselves. I mentioned before, there's something called negative self-talk. This is one of the most toxic things that we do to ourselves. Now, what does this look like? Basically, this is when we find that we've made a mistake, or maybe we haven't achieved something that we want, or we feel like we failed. And instead of having compassion for ourselves, so take for example, if a friend of yours, a spouse, a sister, a brother, a child came to you and said, you know, I made a mistake. I failed at this thing, right? I didn't get this right. Imagine how you would speak to that individual. Well, hopefully you would not tell them things like, you know, you're such a failure. You're never actually going to get this right. You're always going to be a failure, and you'll never, ever be successful. And you know what? You're ugly and you're fat also. Like, can you imagine if you talk to someone like that, right? Now, what am I getting at? What I'm getting at here is that this is similar to how some people speak to themselves, right? When we feel like we've done something wrong, or we feel like we failed, how do we speak to ourselves? Do we talk to ourselves like this? Do we say, you're never going to get this right. You're always failing. You're always messing up. You're so stupid. You're so stupid. Or I'm so stupid. I'll never succeed. I'm such a failure. That type of self-talk is absolute poison. It is absolutely toxic. And it is destroying ourselves from the inside. It is destroying our own relationship with ourselves. Imagine if we talk that way to our spouse or to our best friend or to our child. It would destroy that relationship. And that's exactly what's happening internally with our own relationship with ourselves. And so we have to be conscious of this, and we have to be aware that the way we speak to ourselves is extremely important in terms of how strong our own worth will be. And if you can imagine every time we make a mistake, that we go and we take out a whip and we start whipping ourselves. You know, many people are so much harder on themselves even than others are on them. Or sometimes what happens is that we may have had a critical parent in our upbringing, or a critical teacher. And then what happens is we internalize that critic, So we internalize the voice of our parent or of that individual. Maybe it was a critical spouse. Some people spend years, sometimes decades, in abusive marriages, in marriages where there is verbal abuse, where there is emotional or physical abuse. And then what happens is, unfortunately, is that hearing that type of verbal, that verbal abuse for so long, not only does it damage a person's worth, but it's that person sometimes starts to internalize that voice, and they start to do it to themselves. They start to think that way of themselves. I've heard of women who used to have a healthy self-image, who used to have very, strong self-worth, and after being in a toxic marriage, after being in an abusive or verbally and emotionally abusive, maybe also physically abusive relationship for so long, it completely destroyed their self-worth. They started to believe those things that they were being told, and they started to internalize it so that they were actually saying those things to themselves. We have to break this. We have to get out of these toxic relationships. We have to get out of these toxic environments, and we have to stop these toxic habits. The self-talk is absolutely essential in terms of whether or not we become healthy internally, and whether or not we have a healthy relationship with ourselves and in order for us to really be able to have a healthy relationship with others, including the Creator.